Starting from the Summer of Love, the famous American music festival of Woodstock, there's been one thing that's been common across all concerts since then. People swing their lights, whether it's a Zippo or a cigarette lighter or mobile flashlights, at the behest of the performer. Something similar happened in India on April 5th, at the behest of Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
5 April ko raat 9 baje mombatti, diya, torch ya mobile ki flashlight jalaye.
As a psychologist, I believe that just like how it happens in concert, for the crowd to feel absolutely connected, to feel oneness with the performers, they generally use a torchlight to ignite that unity within the public. And somewhere I feel that Modi ji is also trying to do something of the same sorts with us.
This is his second act of mass motivation in the last couple of weeks. The first one was a one-day voluntary lockdown that he asked 1.3 billion Indians to stay indoors for one day on March 22nd, almost as if it was a trial for the actual lockdown that was announced 2 days later.
We are halfway through the lockdown period. And understandably, there's been a lot of anxiety and tension within the system. And it acted as a great morale booster to the Indian populace. Now, looking at the data, there are, of course, signs of hopeful optimism. But one can very reasonably expect some form of extension being announced in the coming days and weeks.
Somewhere, I believe that this is a sign that something bigger is coming ahead, and somewhere we need to feel ready, because only if we are in it together will we be ready to, and be open to what is going to be the next step.
We've seen a lot of other global leaders from Canada to Europe to Australia communicating statistics and data to the people of their country, asking them to comply with the rules and guidelines. But Modi has left that to his administration. Instead, he's solely focused on the last man on the street, the larger population, and keeping their morale up. The last man on the street in India does not understand fully what's happening around him and what he's supposed to do in this coronavirus pandemic.
I am not talking of the content of what he's spoken. I am talking about the psychological impact of the way he said what he said.
उस रोशनी में उस उजाले में हम अपने मन में ये संकल्प करें कि हम अकेले नहीं है.
Psychiatrically speaking, it's terrific. It's what we call positive reinforcement to the ultimate. And there's another aspect to it as well. Every person then gets involved and kind of is made to feel that he's performing a role. He's doing something special. He's also an important cog in the final wheel that will get us to gain control over this pandemic.
One side there's science, which is equally important, and the other side is the practical approach or bringing people in together, responsibility to become a part of this. And thus it's important for us to know the correct information timely to take care of ourselves.
Yes, it is true that in these unprecedented times, just a diktat would make sure that a population of a billion plus people will follow the rules and guidelines. They have to be motivated, but at the same time, they have to be given clear, credible information so that they can plan their lives ahead in these challenging times. Both are important. Thank you.